This is what your counts should look like. 32 heart pieces, 71 gold skulltulas. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. Make sure you have both of your fire there. Well, blue fire from the cavern. And defrost our good friend, the Zora King, I guess. It's not much of a king, per se. I mean, he doesn't really do all that much up here that I know of. Anyway, now you want to go down here and chat with him. I believe you have to chat with him from over here. Oh, I've come back to life. Was it you who saved me? Don't be nervous. It looks like you have a hard time breathing underwater. And he gives you a little token that we could have used actually in the last part, or I should say near the end of the last part to get to the bottom of the lake. The Zora Tunic. This lets me basically breathe underwater like a fish somehow. I don't know how a piece of clothing will help you do that, but it does. Now what you want to do is defrost the shop, if you'd like to. This is just to do it later in case I have to like buy another tunic due to a like or something like that later. And that would tick me off greatly if I had to do that. And now go through here. And the shop is open once again. The Zora tunic is very, very pricey. Don't you dare lose it! I would prefer losing my shield over the Zora's tunic. Anyway, now I'm going to be doing a couple more things before I get out of here. If you didn't see that, it is over here at over there is Hyrule Castle, actually, where I just came out of. I decided to actually leave Zora's Domain to do some other stuff over here because of the fact that I can't get everything in Zora's Domain anyway right away. So I figured, let's just save it for later. And down here, you can either use the gold scale or the iron boots to get this, but I'm going to use the iron boots just because I have them, and just to demonstrate them a little bit more. And now I can use the Kokiri boots to get out of here. I'm not exactly sure if I should just like go right over to the temple right away, or if I should do some more side quests, because this part is going to be short otherwise. I don't want to start the temple in a... Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, there we go. I don't want to start the temple in, like, the middle of a part if I don't have to. So, yeah, I think I'm actually going to do a bunch of side quests, even if this part ends up being a little bit short at the moment. Anyway, I'm going to warp to Lake Hylia. Well, I should say I already warped to Lake Hylia. Despite it pouring rain here, the whole place is dried up. Down there is the water temple if you want to go to it right now with your iron boots and Zora's tunic. But what I want to do is go back over to the scientist's house, that one up there, and do a thingamabob. If you recall, I said that there was a crate way at the bottom that had a gold skulltula. Now that I have the iron boots, I can actually get that. When you have the iron boots, you can actually roll underwater and break crates. I will bet any money that's going to be used for a puzzle later. So, let's switch off. And you know what? I might as well put on my Zora's tunic right away, just for the heck of it. And fall all the way down to the bottom. I suppose I could get those rupees if I wanted to. What is this? Is that a very poorly drawn pixelated shark? I have no idea. Whoops, I would like to roll. Thank you. And oops, I forgot. You can't pull out your sword underwater. Your only means of defense underwater is the hookshot. So, get out your hookshots, kill that skulltula, get yourself a token. And I'm going to grab this rupee right away. And I think what I'm going to do is go to another location and see if I can get some more stuff before I enter the temple. I just feel uncomfortable leaving it like this and just starting the temple in the middle of everything. Yeah, especially the water temple, because who knows, it may actually be worse than I remember it for whatever reason, but I distinctly remember the water temple being easier. Anyway, time to go somewhere else. Alright, back at Kokiri Forest, I planted a bean here. I don't believe it's actually important to getting anything, but I'm gonna take it for a ride just to see where it can take me, basically. It's taking me for a grand tour around the village, I guess. Maybe it'll lead me up here or something like that, like a shortcut to the Lost Woods? Maybe? Well, I could, like, jump down or jump over there if I wanted to. Where's it gonna end up? Oh! I see what it wants out of me. It wants me to wait for it to go all the way around just to get those rupees. That seems kind of excessive, especially with how much these beans cost. So I guess this is a completely optional bean, because I don't see anything whatsoever that this platform could take me to other than a shortcut back to the Lost Woods, which is where I'm going to next, actually, for a Skulltula, since these beans have grown up so nicely, and... Ooh, there we go. So, I'll see you back at the Lost Woods. You remember that spot with the Deku Scrubs? That's the place that I'm going to. The only spot, actually, in the Lost Woods with the Deku Scrubs, the whole field of them, that has the bean patch. So let's just cut forward. Remember, at the water, turn left, and then turn left again, and then you'll come to this place. Now, what does this take me to? A ledge, perhaps? It seems to be an important place since it's so thin and out of the way. I believe there's a Skulltula here, if I'm not mistaken, unless it's at a higher up place. Uh-oh! I just seen it. Okay, it is a little bit higher. I was a teeny bit too impatient there. Okay, so you're gonna take me... Huh? What? Okay. So is there a way up there? Like, by hookshot, or can I climb up there? Or at least... Can I, like, shoot it? This is quite the mystery. Or maybe that wasn't a Skulltula that I seen up there. Oh, wait! It's because it's daytime! I'm an idiot, once again. Who would have expected that? Well, definitely me. I guess I won't cut forward, because I have to kind of show you the way anyway, so I might as well. Because the area slightly changes at night, I'm sure, maybe. I don't know. It's just, like, really close by, so... Ah, there you are. There you are. Okay, here's what I think I'm gonna do. I looked, and there's absolutely nothing else that I can do at this time, except for one thing at Zora's River. So I'm going to go to the Water Temple and save my game there and then start it in this part. But I'm not going to start the Water Temple today. I'm just going to cut forward to a different day that I'm going to be working on the place. So I don't want to, like, stay at this place for a long time if it's going to... I mean, you know, if this is actually going to give me some trouble, which I don't think it's going to give me as much trouble as the Fire Temple did. And, oh yeah, that's right, you have to hit this switch above the door. There we go. That's actually some sort of, I don't know, cork or something, and you pull it out, and then it floats over to the surface. See that? I don't know what... It looks like a fish, actually. Maybe it's a fish key of sorts or something like that. Anyway, the entrance to the Water Temple is right here. Oh boy. This killed my childhood. Well, the original version did anyway. So yeah, that's what I'm going to be doing, is cutting forward to a completely different day. It's not going to be a different day for you, it's going to be a different day for me. So I'm just going to cut here, and I'll see you then. 2 days later, I thought I would show you a little pro tip here. Whenever you do, like, a long game that you can't reset something that you've already done, whenever you go to your save file screen, like whenever you're going to record another day, what you should do is copy your save files. This is the one that I use for the walkthrough. This is my copy, and I just continuously do this throughout the entire walkthrough. That way, if something goes wrong, I can always go back and delete my main file, and then copy over the backup file. Anyway, Water Temple! I believe the first thing that you want to do is go all the way to the bottom, which means that you have to switch on your iron boots, and you're gonna have to do that a lot. Trust me on this. If I'm not mistaken, I believe you have to go to the bottom first and meet up with a certain Zora. Is this? No, I don't think that's it. There's four pathways on each floor. There's three floors. Wait, maybe this is it. It could be it. Is it it? Yes, it is. There we go. Guess who it is? If I'm right, Link? You're Link, aren't you? It's me, your fiancé. What? Even he's stunned. I don't recall any vows. I recall getting sort of roped into that and... Yeah, do you happen to know where the long shot is in this place? Yeah, it is a pretty bad place going. I mean, it is pretty bad in Zora's domain right now, but what can you do? I'll try and defrost you guys, but what else is there to do? But I just gotta do this temple, I suppose, and not do you, and yeah. I will, and hopefully I'll be able to refill Lake Hylia by doing this as well. And three places to change the water level. That is another big gimmick of this place, besides the whole iron boots thing, is that the issue is the water level controls various things throughout this entire dungeon. So you gotta keep in mind certain things that float and certain things that cork up other stuff when they're not floating, and you get the idea, or at least I think you will. I hope you will, and I'm supposed to go up here, I think. There we go. See these Triforce thingies on the wall here? Play the Zelda's Lullaby, and yes, you gotta do this many, many times throughout this dungeon, which is another annoying aspect of it, to drain and raise the water level. This one, I believe, drains it all the way down to the bottom, if I'm not mistaken. Now, what I want to do here is, I believe I want to land on the second level, if at all possible, if I'm not mistaken. I'm just going to drop down. I'm pretty sure I've seen a hookshot target somewhere around in here, because I need to... Or maybe I don't need to. This is Master Quest we're talking about here. So let's just move on. That upper door was blocked off. I noticed that there's none of those spike ball enemies that like to roll around here, which is pretty strange. They usually hang around this area. I can go in here. So, well, let's actually see what else I can do. Nothing there, alright. So I'm going in here. See that platform that I was just on? Like, this platform here, these things float, and there's actually a hidden room underneath this block here, so keep that in mind. Hookshot target? Ah, there we go. This I can work with. I knew they were going to be there because they were there in the original. Another place to raise the water that raises it to level 2, but is that something that I desire? That is the question. That door will lead you back outside to the second floor, which is, can I actually go out this? Yeah, I can go out there safely. There's a little block here for whatever reason. I don't recall if that does anything, but it certainly stands out. Oops. I wanted to go into first person mode, but evidently I can't do that. wait, there's no more hookshot targets? Well, I guess I have to raise the water level to level 2. Oh no. And see that? Oh, there's a gate blocking the area right now, so I guess I can't do anything with that right now. So let's climb up here. Maybe there's another place that I can aim towards now that I... Maybe there? That seems too far away, though. Yeah, I need the long shot for that. Unless I was supposed to come in here when the water level was at its highest? That doesn't seem logical. And again, what is logical about the water temple? there's that switch there, which I don't know what it does. So let's go press Z switch. That opens that, apparently. Why is that timed anyway? I don't know. I guess maybe it's something that, like, maybe you'll want to... Or maybe the puzzle is that you can't go back, and that would ruin a puzzle in the future or something like that. Nope. Uh-oh. I hear a Skulltula. And it is a false. Don't know why you're here to ruin the fun. Ah, there we go. this is pretty linear so far, I think. There's only, like, one place to go everywhere that the water level is raised. Where is the Skulltula, friend? Huh? Is it here? Is it in here? Oh, it's probably in there. Okay. Well, what was the point of this room, then? Is it something like... Am I supposed to shoot... Because I remember... Oh, okay, well, that works. I guess that's the point of this room. Because I remember in the Fire Temple, there was those faces on the wall that you could shoot that were, ow, why didn't you turn around, Link? That you could shoot and you would be able to get in, or not get into. They were either, like, switches or that you could shoot them to get things. Hookshot target there. Hopefully I'll be able to latch on to, yeah, I can. There we go. And let's see, switch. What's the whole point of this? Does this, like, open a gate somewhere else? Because that just leads me right back to the main room. Unless that was to access the water level. And look at all the crates reset. That was fast. They really built those crates in a hurry. Let's just see here, just for the fun of it. If I were... No, wait, actually, I... No, I'll remember that the Skulltula's there. Okay, it's right there. Well, that opens with something. Okay, let's just keep going on. I betcha I have to raise the water level again for whatever reason. Unless I'm supposed to use the water level at its second point to get myself into those middle rooms back at those first rooms that I was at. Yeah, because that isn't the place where I raised the water level from. The place where I raised the water level from on the third level was somewhere around... I'll know it when I see it. I think it is... No, that's not it. That's the way to the boss. Oh, it's on the third level, dang it. Or at least it was in the original. And actually, you know what I'm gonna do? It's getting kind of lengthy in this part, so I'm going to end it off here. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next part when we explore some more rooms down this passage. Hopefully we'll be able to, like, get the dungeon map or something like that, because I think I'm gonna be confused if I don't. Doo-doo-doo!